Hi everyone, I'm Karen Snow from ChristianCelebrationIdeas.com, and today I'm going to show you how to put your tree together, decorate your tree, with just a few ideas on how to do it like a pro. The first thing we want to do is start with your tree. A lot of you have real trees, and I have an artificial tree. I live with a fireman, so we're not allowed to have real trees in our house. But no matter what the tree, you can make it look wonderful just by using a few pointers. The first thing is the lights. The lights are really important. I know that most people put too few lights on. So let me give you a little rule of thumb. It should be about 100 lights per foot of tree. So this is a 7-foot tree. I should have about 700 on here. I have 900 on here, and I could probably have as many as 1200, depending on how many you have and how many you like. I know that a lot of you have already the artificial pre-lit trees, and those are wonderful because you don't have to go to all the trouble to put the lights on. But I always add, when I do them for clients, I always add a few more lights. So think about that too. So I have 900 lights on this tree. You could go as high as 1200. The second thing you do after your lights is put on your garland. In this tree, I have a netted garland, which is a wide netting. It comes in a big roll, and it's wonderful, especially for artificial trees. Well, for real trees too, because you can hide things, and kind of when you have a pocket where there isn't a branch or something, you can tuck in this netting. Now I've already gone ahead and done it, but let me show you a couple tricks. One is, don't go round and round and round the tree. Tuck it in and go randomly around the tree. Tuck it in, squish it in, have some of it sticking out. Just keep going around the tree and tucking it in all the way around. Scrunch it all together so it's not one big wide piece. And you can see that just adds a whole lot to the base of the tree. And then I've used two different ribbons. You can use wide ribbon, but you can use two or three different ribbons. I've used kind of a gold here with a brown leaf on it because I'm doing a woodland tree. I love a themed tree because it kind of gives you an idea where you're going. It's really fun though too if you just have an eclectic tree where you've got maybe your kids' ornaments on there, the ones they've made all year for you all through the years. This particular one is a woodland tree. It has to do with our family loves camping, so all through the years, probably for about 6 years now, we've collected about 150 ornaments that are all woodland inspired. There's moose and deer and raccoons and Santas on skis and camping tents and lanterns and binoculars. So I'm going to add 150 ornaments to this tree. And then once I get the ornaments on, we're going to add some further embellishments like some balls. Now, something that's really important on a tree, on any tree, no matter what size, is to have different sized elements. Don't just have all tiny balls. Most people use balls about this size, and this is the only ball they use. But I suggest that you get some really big things, some medium-sized things, and then some smaller things, because you've got some really big branches on the bottom and some smaller branches on the top. So you want to vary the sizes of your ornaments. And I also have a great big bear that I put in the tree, and I've got some big reindeer that I put in the tree. So just vary the sizes of your ornaments and try and get some really big elements into it, and that makes it really interesting. So I'm going to go ahead and put all the ornaments on, and I'll be back in just a minute. Don't be afraid to put some larger kind of unexpected things on the tree. As you can see here, I've got one of my kids' teddy bears from when they were little because it's a woodland tree. I've got bears. I've got some really big balls and some medium size, and then you can see some tinier ones, well, kind of towards the back. I've got smaller pine cones, a little bit bigger, bigger, and then even some sugary ones right here and bigger here. So you just kind of kept the theme. I've kept the theme to woodland with pine cones and all the different little critters and fishermen. And then I put some big elements and some smaller elements, played with my ribbon all the way through and kind of retucked it in. I've got a big pine cone Santa. I've got some pine cone light covers, and it took me, like I said, about 5 years to collect all this. And for newlyweds or somebody who wants to start a theme tree, you don't have to have all this stuff all at once. Go out and find some pretty ribbon and garland, and then maybe find a few elements like the pine cone balls or something like that. And then even just fill in with some ribbon and ribbon bows and things like that for the first year or two until you get some things collected. And as you go through the year, wherever you go on your travels or just to different cities, you can always find, if you've got a theme in your head, you can always find something that goes with it. some of the cutest themed trees were kids' trees with toys and candy and all those kinds of things. I love a themed cross tree, a Christian cross tree. I've seen some that are just beautiful, and they're just all different kinds of crosses. So just kind of let your imagination go, really have fun with it, and then put the ornaments completely cover the tree. Fuller the better. Little tiny sparse trees, they just don't have an impact. And like for instance here, I had kind of a hole in the tree, so I took one of my big balls and kind of pushed it in there. They're not hanging, they're pushed into the tree. Most of my stuff is either sitting on a branch or pushed into the tree so that they really kind of tell a story. And all the little pockets everywhere you look, way even tucked way inside, you'll see a little ornament. So just have fun with it, and I hope your tree turns out beautiful this year, and Merry Christmas.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories.